afternoon. It's good to be here today. It's a day of celebration. I just want to tell all the eighth graders real quick that you guys all look so good. And girls, you look beautiful. And men, you look so handsome. And today's a good day. We're coming together to celebrate. Celebrate many efforts of dorm staff and teachers and counselors. And most of all, the eighth graders that worked hard to get here. Family members, we're glad that you're here and made it safe. And we're just going to continue to thank God for his goodness and all that he's done. And so we're going to go to the Lord in prayer right now. And when we go to the Lord in prayer, what we're doing is we're asking him to continue that good work. And today I'm going to ask that he continues that good work for each of you. That when you go home this summer, that you're going to make good decisions, the decisions that helped get you to this place. But don't let this be the end of your achievement. This is just the beginning. And I know that you have the ability to be successful because this is your first step in success. And we want you to know that we're very proud of you. We're here to support you. So let's go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we come to you this day, Lord. We thank you and we praise you for the day that you've given us. God, that we can come together for a good reason, a celebration. Father, a collaboration of the family and Riverside and all the students, Lord. And this is what the product is, Lord. Father, we thank you for giving traveling mercies to each one that is here, all the family members, Lord. We ask, Lord, that you would just continue to keep your hand upon them, Lord, as they travel home for all our students, Lord. Keep your hand upon them this summer, Lord. Wherever they may go, whatever they may do, just remind them that they're not alone, that they have many good things to look forward to. We serve a good God, a mighty God, a loving God, and a forgiving God. Father, I thank you right now for all that you've done and for all that you're doing in all of our lives, that we can witness, Father, your faithfulness. Father, we thank you for the joy that we have in our hearts today. We look to you and we give you thanks and appreciation. We love you. We pray you continue to be with each one here in Jesus' name. And everybody said, amen.
Good afternoon. I'd like to welcome all of the parents who were able to attend this occasion. You do know eighth graders that you're not going to be eighth graders ever again. This is a momentous time for you, and we're proud of you. We are, I know your parents are proud of you. The staff is certainly proud of you, and we wish you the best for the next 4 years. You still have, it's just a beginning. You still have some time to go yet. We hope you'll return to Riverside next year. I'd like to introduce some people to you who work in your behalf. We're a little short with our school board members because the weather across the United States really affected plane flights. But we have Ms. Ramona Tanawashi from the Confederated Tribes of Oregon. That she was stranded in Dallas and slept in an airport, so I'm really pleased that she could get here in time for this. We have Mr. Ernest Redbird representing the Kiowa. And we expected Mr. Albert Pablo representing the Pima. However, he was stuck in Chicago, so we're not quite sure when he's going to get here. The other one school board member could not come because he's fighting fire down on the Apache, White Mountains. So we're all very, very busy, but they did want to be here and they would welcome you also, especially the parents who took time out because this is a Thursday to come and see their eighth graders. We're really proud of you. You look great, as usual. And we hope you have a safe summer. and that you make good choices so that we'll see you back here next year.
I'd like to introduce our other guests on the stage. Mrs. Sharon Sadoghi, she's our elementary junior high counselor. I'm sure each and every one of you have visited with her at least once this year. And our next platform guest is Katie Bertucci, and she's the valedictorian for our graduating high school class. And then Ms. Sandri Paisakai, she's our elementary junior high teacher, as well as being a pastor. I'd also like to ask any of the staff from Riverside that's here to stand up so we can show our appreciation to the students. Any staff from the other side. Thank you, and we appreciate your support.
I will rise. 8th grade class of Riverside. Good afternoon and welcome visitors, family, and friends. On behalf of the 8th grade class of 2011, I would like to thank you for attending our promotion ceremony. I would like to introduce myself at this time. My name is Alexander Richard Flores, and I'm 15 years old. I belong to the Hilly River Pima Tribe of Arizona. I was born and raised in Arizona. I came to Riverside Indian School during my 5th grade year. Up until that time, I lived on a reservation and I actually like it better than living in the city. My parents are Marcia and George Flores. Luckily, my mother is here with us today. I'd like to thank her for that. I'd like to thank her at this time for her support. Mom, would you please stand? I'd like to thank her for motivating me to maintain high standards. I have 4 brothers and 1 sister. While at Riverside, I participated in several sports. This year I played football, basketball, ran track, and attended powerlifting. My favorite sport is football. I've been attending RIS for 4 years now and hope to continue my educational plan on this campus. I have remained at Riverside Indian School because of my interest in sports, the support of staff and friends. For my classmates, I want to say I hope you continue your education. Education will be your key to a successful future. If you choose to return to Riverside Indian School, that would be great. If you choose to attend other schools, I hope that you continue to learn, make wise decisions, and accomplish your goals. Good luck and everyone have a safe trip home.
Good morning, staff, family, and friends. Good afternoon. My name is Kayla Vitucci, and I am the valedictorian for the senior class of 2011. I come from the Omaha Tribe of Nebraska and have been attending Riverside since 6th grade. When first coming to Riverside, I never expected that I'd be graduating or that I'd be valedictorian for that matter. It isn't easy being here away from family and so far from home. Being here taught me independence and self-reliance. For some of you, this may be your first time away from home. Others are probably used to it. Riverside becomes a second home. You'll make friends and have experiences that you will remember forever. The best thing about coming to Riverside is that you make friends from all over the United States that otherwise you never would have had the chance to meet. Being here today is a great accomplishment for all of you. I remember my 8th grade promotion, the excitement of being done with junior high and on to high school. I hope that you all continue with your education as I plan to. I'm told quite frequently how you have to have your education in order to achieve anything. I want to read you a quote which I feel could apply to all students here. Continuous effort, not strength or intelligence, is the key to unlocking our potential, Winston Churchill. To simplify this, it means you don't have to be strong or really smart to succeed. All you have to do is put your effort into it and not give up. I am graduating tomorrow, and next year I will attend college at the University of Nebraska-Lincoln. I see so much potential here. All you have to do is try. Don't give up. High school will fly by, and then you will either go on to college or look for a job. From this, I would like to leave you with another quote. You have brains in your head. You have feet in your shoes. You can steer yourself in any direction you choose. You're on your own, and you know what you know, and you are the one who will decide where to go. Dr. Seuss, all the places you'll go. It has been truly an honor to address you all this afternoon, and I want to congratulate the 8th grade class on completing your first step in beginning your high school career. Thank you.
Welcome to Riverside Indian School's 8th grade promotion. It's a great honor to be class valedictorian for 2011. My name is Brandy Vitzilli. I'm 14 years old and a member of the Navajo tribe. I was born in Sherbrooke, New Mexico and raised in Farmington, New Mexico. I've been attending Riverside for 2 years and lived in Comanche Dorm. My parents are Penny Nez and Darren Curley. I have 4 sisters, 2 young and 2 old. Would my family please stand? The person I look up to is my older sister, Samantha. I look up to her because she has encouraged me to keep going, and also she's been there for me through thick and thin, and I'd like to thank her for that. I've been selected to be a part of the National Junior Honor Society, NJHS, Student Council, Gifted and Talented, and also Math Counts. This year I participated in basketball and softball. I enjoyed basketball because it has inspired me and taught me that if I fall down, I need to get back up and keep trying. Riverside has taught me to be responsible, be respectful, be independent, and to be a leader. Riverside Indian School is not only the oldest boarding school, but is the best. Today I say to my fellow classmates, congratulations, you made it. Keep reaching your goals and dreams. Have a positive attitude. Never say you can't. Don't let anyone bring you down. Keep your head high and make the right choices. I challenge you, my classmates, to walk across the stage again in 2015. I'd like to thank everyone for coming here tonight. Have a safe trip home. Thank you.
Welcome all the parents, the grandparents, the aunties and the uncles, the brothers and the sisters, and any other family members that are here to honor these 8th grade students. Good afternoon, young men and young ladies. It's with great pleasure that I get to speak with you today. Today is the last time that you and I will meet together as a group. So it's a very special time for me. Last night at the Baccalaureate, Mr. Yago made a comment about the 8th grade, how their teachers baby you, and that you're not going to get that when you get to high school. He didn't mean that your teachers wouldn't care for you. What he meant was, you're making a giant step to adulthood, and your learning will be your own responsibility when you enter high school. Your teachers aren't going to be there to push and pull like they did this year. I only pray that you can remember half of the things that you and I talked about. The positive things, life changes, dealing with frustration, dealing with anger, making good decisions, and yes, even our sex education talks. I hope you remember at least half of that. I can only pray that you will maintain a part of the academia that your teachers have put upon you, tried to help you learn. They've worked with you, they've pressured you, praised you, prayed for you, scolded you, became frustrated with you, but most importantly, they rejoiced in every success you had, whether it was large or small. They were right there cheering you on. And they will continue to watch you as you go along in Riverside. Right now, today, you probably can't wait to get out of their classrooms, but next fall, they're going to be at the door pushing you out, I guarantee it. Right, teachers? Eighth grade staff, would you please stand as I call your name for an introduction? Mrs. Cheryl Redelk, she teaches math and United States history. Ms. Judith Hunter, she's our language arts teacher. Let's just hold our applause till the very end, okay? Mrs. Stephanie Ware, Math and Science. Ms. Sandy Tessitai. And Mr. James Gregory. He's up there. These are our resource lab people. Mr. Christopher Dobson, Health and PE. Support staff, as I introduce you, would you please stand? Elizabeth French. Okay, she's preparing for the reception. She does our 21st century. Todd Dobson. Right here. And Jeannie Paul. These are education techs working with the eighth grade. Do I have any eighth grade coaches present today? Mr. Yeager, will you please stand? He was our girls basketball coach. We had a very, very successful season. Do I have any other coaches? Coach Nails? Coach Nails, cross country and spring track. These are the people that work with your children every day. May we please have a round of applause for all of these adults. We have a lot of programs on campus for your children to try to encourage them to grow academically and socially. We try to meet every need for every child. We have a program that's very popular here on campus. It's called the A-Plus program. The A-Plus program is designed for age-inappropriate students to re-enter their proper grade. It's a self-motivated program, and it takes a lot of dedication and responsibility on the part of the students. In some cases, it has helped students who required a lot of one-on-one attention and assistance, and they may not have been age inappropriate, but they needed that program to keep them going. And going on to the ninth grade, because of the assistance received through the A-Plus program, our Tyler Jacket. Will you please stand, Tyler? And Mendel Cato. Will you please stand, Mendel? Let's give each other a hand. We have some others who moved through up to the high school through the A-Plus program, but they're not here for the ceremony. They're Damian Lee, Alexis Naaha, Jeremy Richards, Anthony Seekingland, and Isaac Shaveria. They went on to the high school and have earned high school credits. Mr. T.J. Sheridan, will you please stand? Right here to my left. He works diligently to assist these A-plus students, and let's give him a big round of applause. Mrs. Stephanie Ware coordinates the Gifted and Talented program. If you're in the Gifted and Talented program, would you please stand? These young people are selected for the Gifted and Talented program based on national test scores. They have to score like in the 90th percentile or better. Academic ethics, leadership, performing arts, and we're very unique in that in our performing arts, we consider our Native American culture. Let's give these young people a round of applause. You may be seated. You may have noticed that some of the students, when they came in, they were wearing the cords on their neck, the gold and the blue and the white cords. These young people are members of the National Junior Honor Society. Students, will you please stand? NJHS, please stand. Young men and young women, the certificate and the card and the pen that you received at your induction, they'll go with you, even if you don't come back to Riverside, because this is a national organization. You'll be recognized, whether you come back to us or go somewhere else. You are a member of an elite national society. Visitors and guests, please look at these young people. This is the cream of the crop academically. They each of them had to maintain at least a 3.0 grade point average over the last three school years. For the most part, they've shown good decision-making skills, they practice good citizenship, and they've given service to our school and the community at large in a variety of ways. This is a tribute not only to these young people, but to you. And the reason why is they see how you value education and they're following your lead. So give them and yourselves a round of applause. You may be seated. I would like to introduce and invite Mrs. Sharon Hunter, our principal, to join me at this time for these special presentations. Alexander Flores, will you come forward, please? Alex has attended Riverside for 4 years. He's earned a 3.56 GPA, grade point average, to be named the salutatorian for his class. Alex, the son of Mrs. Marsha Flores of Levine, Arizona, is a member of the Gila River Tribe. He's involved in National Junior Honor Society, Math Counts, and the Gifted and Talented program. His athletic participation includes football, basketball, track, and powerlifting, and he will come back to us next year. Brandy Bitsilly, will you come forward, please? Okay. Brandy is a member of the Navajo Nation from Kirtland, New Mexico, and she's been named the valedictorian for our eighth grade class. She's attended Riverside for 2 years and has maintained a 3.69 grade point average. As she's active in the National Junior Honor Society, Gifted and Talented, Student Council, and Math Counts. She's the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Darren and Penny Nez Curley. She participates in basketball and softball. She also plans to come back to us in the fall. So congratulations to these two.
This time I'd like to present the eighth grade class gift to the valedictorian of the high school, Kaylee Batusi.
Will the eighth grade class please stand?
From Farmington, New Mexico, a member of the Seneca Cayuga tribe, Minariba Namino. From San Carlos, Arizona, a member of the San Carlos Apache tribe, Fitzgerald Thompson. From Kirtland, New Mexico, a member of the Navajo Nation, Brandy Bitsilly. Brandy. from San Carlos, Arizona, a member of the San Carlos Apache tribe, Rolando Henry. From Macy, Nebraska, a member of the Omaha Tribe of Nebraska, Shalisa Sheridan. From Albuquerque, New Mexico, a member of the Zuni Tribe, Kaylin Lucio. From Pine Ridge, South Dakota, a member of the Oglala Sioux Tribe, Alicia Goodplume. From Black River Falls, Wisconsin, a member of the Ho-Chunk Nation, Lawrence Carbisia. From Sacaton, Arizona, a member of the Gila River Pima Tribe, April Jackson. From Levine, Arizona, a member of the Gila River Tribe, Alexander Flores. From Cibacue, Arizona, a member of the White Mountain Apache Tribe, Denitra Lee. From Box Elder, Montana, a member of the Chippewa Cree, Gabriel Jordan. From White River, Arizona, a member of the White Mountain Apache Tribe, Demetria Settle. From White River, Arizona, a member of the White Mountain Apache Tribe, Martin Wallen. From Stanfield, Arizona, a member of the Tohono O'odham Tribe, Nicole Wan. From Cortez, Colorado, a member of the Butte Mountain Tribe, Tyler Jacket. From Fruitland, New Mexico, a member of the Navajo Nation, Deidreal Augustine. From Ada, Oklahoma, a member of the Seminole tribe, Deacon Cruz. From Warm Springs, Oregon, a member of the Confederated Tribes of Warm Springs, Aldo Antunes. From Wyola, Montana, a member of the Crow Tribe of Montana, Travis Cummins. From Anadarko, Oklahoma, a member of the Kiowa tribe, Candanese Sadongi. From White River, Arizona, a member of the White Mountain Apache tribe, Rendell Caddo. From Bakersfield, California, a member of the Ho-Chunk Nation, Selena St. Cyr. From Bob's Elder, Montana, a member of the Chippewa Cree Tribe, Lyle Ahenecue. From Warm Springs, Oregon, a member of the Confederated Tribes of Warm Springs, Jamie Warner. Woo! From Canton, Oklahoma, a member of the Cheyenne and Arapaho Tribes, John White Eagle III. From Macy, Nebraska, a member of the Omaha Tribe of Nebraska, Elijah Parker. From Apache, Oklahoma, a member of the Wichita Tribe, Gerald Wetzeline. From San Carlos, Arizona, a member of the San Carlos Apache tribe, Alyssa McIntosh. From San Carlos, Arizona, a member of the San Carlos Apache tribe, Cynthia Miller. From Levine, Arizona, a member of the Pima Thon Otham tribes, Selena Flores. Oh. from Anadarko, Oklahoma, a member of the Comanche Nation, Rachel Bates.
Will the 8th grade class of 2011 please stand? Having satisfactorily completed the course of study prescribed by the State of Oklahoma and the Bureau of Indian Education, and by the power vested to me as the elementary junior high principal by the Riverside Board of Education, I now pronounce you promoted to the 9th grade.
Congratulations, 9th graders. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Aholodoki, for this day you've given us, dear Lord, that you've created this wonderful event that we can come and celebrate the accomplishments of these young people who have worked diligently this past 9 months, dear Lord. We ask that you continue to be with them on this journey that they've begun, this journey that will take them to many different places, and by your grace and mercy, dear Lord, that they will go and achieve great things and do great things with their lives. We ask that you continue to bless their parents and their loved ones and their family, dear Lord. And they continue to support them and lift them up and encourage them in a good way, Heavenly Father. We just thank you so much for the opportunity that they've given this school, the honor that they've given us to take care of their young ones, dear Lord. It's such a wonderful thing to watch these young people grow, not only physically, dear Lord, but academically and emotionally and spiritually, Heavenly Father. We just thank you for all of that. I ask you to continue to be with all of the students and staff here at Riverside as we continue to celebrate the accomplishments of our students and all the class of 2011, dear Lord. And I just lift these things up to you. In the glory of your Son, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Reception to follow in the cafeteria. You're all welcome to come. Thank you. Gotta get everything.
Here you go, guys.